Hey guys, welcome back to Auto Repair Guys. In today's video guys, we'll be working here on a Dodge Journey guys, and if you have one from 2009 to 2019, the video will be very helpful to you guys. We'll be showing you how to replace camshaft position sensors. We'll be demonstrating on the 3.6, but even if you have a different engine guys, subscribe. We'll be making more than 200 videos and we're constantly getting new vehicles, so every vehicle we get we'll make 200 videos on it at least. Now, we'll demonstrate on that 3.6 how to remove and replace the camshaft position sensors. You have two of them because it's a V6 engine. One is bank one, one is bank two. Bank one is on the rear cylinder head right there. Bank two is on the front cylinder head. Now you can see on the valve cover right here, this piece guys, this is your camshaft position sensor. And this is your camshaft position sensor as well, two of them. Now depending on the code, you know which one you need to replace, and we'll have more videos about the codes on our new channel guys, Electrical Car Repair Life. Please check it out. So stay with us, we'll show you how to disassemble all that stuff and get to the camshaft position sensors and remove and replace them now. So next we just need to get a flathead screwdriver. Get that clamp loose now. Okay, let's see if we can get that boot out. Yep, perfect. And then there is one more clamp right there. Okay, we're getting this one out now. So now we just grab it and we gently need to pull that thing out, careful not to break any vacuum hoses in the way or anything like that. Okay, you can see it came like that. So now we have one rubber glide right here. This one, in our case, looks like it's broken. You have two more on the back side. Okay, they're like, you'll feel them, one right here, one over there. And what do you need to do? Okay, you need to pull straight up to come out of the rubber bushings, and after that, okay, this sensor here for the temperature, intake temperature sensor, pull that one out, and when it's out of the other two sensors, okay, all we have to do now, just start pulling it out. Okay, and now we just need to mess with it, okay, until we get it out. I think it will come out only one way, because there is one thing holding on the bottom. So let me figure out, okay, which way this thing will come out. And we'll show you what is the easiest way to remove it. So what we'll do, we'll actually remove that little hose, it's in the way. Okay, so let me get this one out of here now. If the engine is hot, never do that because it's part of the cooling system. Okay, you don't want to burn yourself because it could be under enormous amount of pressure. So, okay, it got loose now. You might be able to do it without removing the hose. Okay, but I wouldn't recommend it. Now, right here there is one clamp on the back side, one plastic retainer that we need to pop up. That way the hose will go down. Okay, like that. And now I think, let's see if we'll be able to pull that guy out of here. Oh, maybe it still will not work, guys. Okay, this thing is ridiculous, I'm telling you. So, I don't know if it will come out without removing the intake manifold, the upper intake. Because there is two. So if you push towards the back, okay, come out like that. I think we almost got it out. Okay, like that. Those are the two, oh yeah, there was a little bit of water. There are two bushings on the back that we need to release in order to pull that thing out. Let me show you where they are on the engine quick. Okay, if you look towards the back side, this is one of them. This is the other one right there. So next, you can remove the whole upper intake together with the, I believe, with the throttle body. We will inspect here in a second, but we will take them apart because we want to make video guys how to replace throttle body, how to clean it as well. We want to clean ours because those are known to give engine light on, engine codes, and a little bit of unstable idling. So we'll be cleaning ours. Check out the video. So with 8mm socket now. Okay, there are four screws that we need to remove. Here we will have to do it by hand. We will not be able to do the impact because it's a little bit of limited room. So one more. So two left. Okay, this, and now we have one more on top holding, but let's remove this one. Perfect. Now we need to disconnect the wires here. Okay, this, you kind of slide it out. Now this wire right here, you can see that's a safety pin. You need to pull that thing, okay, out. Okay, like that. Press down now. Okay, that's perfect. And pull it out. And we got the throttle body out of the way now. So now we need to get 8mm socket and we'll need to start removing a few screws now. For the upper intake, it's very important not to over tighten those later. It says 7 to 9 Newton meters. So we keep doing that now. We'll be fixing a common oil leak on that engine as well. We have so many videos guys. If you have any specific problem, drop a comment below. We'll get the idea about fixing things and also we'll try to make a video for your specific problem. Okay, those are loose now. With 10mm we have to remove two nuts holding the intake right here. That's the upper intake. Okay, perfect. This one's been loose for like 2 seconds and we're still spinning it. Great. Okay, don't drop things like we do. Now we need to start disconnecting a few hoses. We need to also disconnect, okay, here the this will be the map sensor in a little bit. Okay, that map sensor right here. Okay, we need to pull that red thing to the back. Now press down on it and pull pull the wire out, but ours is stuck a little bit. Okay, perfect. Okay, with the clip removal too, we need to remove that holder there. Again, all the tools and parts, guys, that we use will be listed in the description of the video below the video, so please check it out for your convenience. This thing is almost done, we just want to make sure we don't break them, because if we do, we have to replace all that stuff later. Okay, perfect, like that. Now, we have one vacuum hose right here that we'll need to pull out. This one, we might even do it in a little bit when I get to it. Okay, and in the meantime, we'll remove that hose there. Okay, this one, I got it loose, but it's moving now. Okay, it's coming out. Perfect, just careful not to break your intake. Now, we can go ahead, remove that bracket here, that clamp, and we need to pull that hose out now. This one will be stuck, most likely. Okay, like that. Here, we have one more nut holding. Two nuts. Okay, one on this side, one on the other side, with a 10mm socket. So now it's still holding, guys. This bracket right here, we need to go ahead and remove those brackets so we can get it out. Quite a bit of disassembly here. So now we'll be removing that cable here. Okay, over the ball there is one plastic holder for the wires here, so we need to pull that one out. And this one, usually you want to get it a little bit on each side, okay, and then it will come out. If you just try to go on one side, okay, it's not going to come out. Okay, and you can see this one came out. Now we can use, let's see, a wrench, I think, that will actually let us take that ball off. So we're on the left side of the engine now, where we remove the two nuts. So what we'll be doing now, we'll try to remove that nut and bolt and get that bracket out. And if that bracket comes out now, we won't have to mess with the ones on the front. So we want to see which one is easier, guys, so you don't have to do the same amount of work that we do. Probably save you a little bit of headache. Okay, this nut is almost out. Perfect. So what we did right here now, okay, we pull that bracket of the bolt here. Okay, you can see I pulled it out, and then I pulled it up like that. Now we're going to use a 13mm deep socket to remove that bolt, and this bracket should come out, hopefully. Okay, so we have extension with the deep socket 13. And we're trying to remove that bolt now. Whoever thought of that design, guys, I think they wanted you to go to the dealership, because that's quite a bit of work. Okay, we need to just pull it out in a little bit. Perfect. It's right there. Now we'll just grab it, pull the bolt out. Okay, this is what it looks like. Let me show you a little bit more. Okay, it goes this way. on the bracket. Now we need to pull that bracket out like that. Okay, and we can just leave it there now. We have one more bolt right here with the 8mm that we need to remove. That's one that we didn't see at first. So we'll go ahead, remove that one now, and then we'll be ready to continue with the next step. Okay, let's see now if we can lift up on this side a little bit and get it out of here. Perfect. So you can see that that saved us quite a bit of headache, guys. Now one of the gaskets, okay, is stuck here. The other ones are over there. You can see that's how they need to be, right here. So we're going to cover the intake now. Make sure that you cover your hole so you don't drop anything. Even I would recommend to put a bigger towel or something, because if you drop something in the valves and you don't notice it, your engine will be done. Okay, now we can pull that piece. It's extremely dirty and dusty usually, so pull that thing out and we can proceed with the next step. So with the upper intake out of the way now, guys, okay, this is bank 1 camshaft position sensor. This is bank 2 camshaft position sensor here. So we need to pull that safety pin back. Okay, and then you're supposed to press down and pull it out, but this one came out pretty easy. Now we'll need to get a Torx 30. Okay, let me show you. Start looking a bit like this one here, and we're going to go ahead and remove that bolt. Okay, that's one long bolt, guys. Now, right here, you can see with a plastic panel remover tool, just pry it up a little bit, then it comes in an angle like that, and you can pull the camshaft position sensor out. Okay, you can see we need to clean ours a little bit, but this is the sensor. Stay with us, and we're going to show you how to install it. All the parts and tools, including replacement sensors, you can find in the description of the video below. Now, the back one, okay, we're not going to show you the back one because the procedure is exactly the same, guys. Disconnect the wire, remove the bolt, pull it out. That's it. You can see, pretty simple. I would recommend to replace the seals as well. Those are replaceable. You just pull them out. But if they're old ones, they'll start leaking. You can see the one on the back is developing a little bit of a leak. So we need to take care of that one. Otherwise, you start smelling a little bit of burning oil. And later inspect that bolt seal here as well, because that could cause a leak as well. And all we have to do, it goes in an angle, then straight, push it like that. Okay, get it tight, and don't forget your cable, guys. From that point on, everything else you have to put together in reverse order that we took it apart. So hopefully, guys, the video will be helpful to you. Please subscribe to your channel for more videos, and see you next time.